Hello, this is Annabeth, and I'm here to show off the little Easter egg that exists in every single episode room in the cantina. There's a small Easter egg, apparently. I'm just going to turn on a couple of extras that will make this slightly less annoying to do. Right, so in here, the Easter egg is, simply put, just this thing. Just a little build of R2-D2 right there. And that's pretty much the entirety of episode 1. In episode 2, however, Easter egg is simply just a disco. That's it. There's also another weird thing here, but I'm not entirely sure this counts as an Easter egg. I'm not even sure what this item is supposed to be exactly, so yeah. Episode 3, I'm not entirely sure it has something that could be considered an Easter egg, really, but it does have something that you don't actually see in any other episode rooms, and that's these two items here that you can just destroy, and that's it. That's all that is. Episode 4 has a hat dispenser. So you know how you got these two levels, you'll get helmet dispensers that will give you stormtrooper helmets. There's also one in the last level of episode 5. There's two in episode 5. In the last two levels. One each in the last two levels of episode 5, actually. There's one actually in Jabba's palace somewhere, but there's also a helmet dispenser that gives you the helmet for Leia's bounty hunter disguise throughout there. But also, and this is a thing you can find in Secret Plans, actually. It's in there somewhere. I might do a bit of a showcase of that existing. Basically, what this does is it gives you... You can have Leia hair. There are other options. Leia hair is not the only option. It just showed up twice in a row. It is randomized. So you can get, like, a top hat, as you can see. Or you can get... there's a baseball cap. And there's also an Indiana Jones hat, I think. I'm going to see if I can find those. Hang on a sec. So... Okay, we're just getting Leia hair and top hats, apparently. Which is kind of annoying, because I really want to see the baseball hat and the Indiana Jones hat showing up. The game really doesn't want to give us the baseball cap or the, okay, so we're just not getting the baseball cap or the Indiana Jones hat, the fedora. So, yeah, that's great. Episode 5 has a snowman. You can actually see the snowman model loaded out of bounds somewhere. But yeah, it's just a snowman. You build the snowman, and then you can destroy the snowman. That's it. That's really not as cool as it sounds. It's just a snowman. And episode 6 is probably one of the most long-winded ones. Because, okay, first things first. You can spin those chairs around. We can put them on the table. We can hover them in the air. Put them back in the table. And then attach them to the ceiling. But yeah, that's the entirety of that. There aren't really too many other Easter eggs. There's really isn't an Easter egg in this room that isn't something that's required for 100%, which I don't particularly count as Easter eggs. It's like, it's part of the game's progression. Okay, can I... There we go. And yeah, and then there's an Easter egg in this room where you can just, you know, force all these cups into place, and you can build this, and as soon as you see this, you can just lift it up, and boom. And then it explodes, because of course it explodes. Why wouldn't it explode? Anyway, as well, if you were to go in here, there's a couple of things. There's also this stud fountain, clearly. Okay, since people are attacking me, I'm going to turn on invincibility. There's whatever this thing is. I'm not 100% sure what it's supposed to be. What is this? You can destroy it, so that's cool. And then there's also this. These random bits of road in the middle of here, and you do that, You push that, and boom, you got a bunch of studs. And also, if you go over here, you can just slam this, and you get, you know, a car. Whee! And you can drive it on the road, I guess. And not only that, but you also get... There's also another car. So there's two cars in the game. Which... You know, kind of cool, I guess. There's no Easter eggs in the Bounty Hunter room, believe me. I would know, because I've spent a lot of time in this game. So yeah, that's pretty much all the, I guess, Easter egg type deal. Like the weird bonus stuff. Like, you don't need any of this stuff to 100% the game, obviously. But it's all here, and it's all kind of cool. I might do other things to show off, so like, some cool secrets in other hubs. Like, I don't think there's really any actual, like, cool secrets in the frickin' LEGO Star Wars 1 or LEGO Star Wars 2 hubs, but there are cool secrets if you go. Like, there is some cool stuff, the secrets you can find in the LEGO Indiana Jones 1 hub. There's some cool stuff you can find in the LEGO Batman hub, and obviously every hub from LEGO Indy 2 onwards is gonna have some cool stuff going on in there. Because, like, there's, like, you know, actual hub puzzles, and there's collectibles hidden in the hub that you can get. You can also, yeah. But before that, hubs had their cool secrets that you never needed to touch for 100%, but they exist, and you can play around with them. So, I don't know, it's just a cool thing that you can do. Also, I like that you can just push this guy around, and he turns into a, and he just shrinks like that. That's actually kind of cool. So, yeah. Thanks for watching, and I'm gonna just, I'm gonna turn into another Ewan McGregor. Now we have two Ewan McGregors. A couple of Ewan McGregors. We're all happy here. Thanks. Bye.